I can use a bit of a rest. What do you think, love?
I think that's a pretty good idea. Mm-hmm. What do you think?
You mean sleep here?
Mm-hmm. Have a good night's sleep here, and then you'll be all fresh to meet Mum tomorrow, eh?
What about the dishes?
Oh, I think I can manage them on my own.
I bet your pajamas are in there.
No, they're my special things.
What, toys?
Other things as well, especially important things. Take them everywhere with me. Give them to me, guys.
Well, I'll lend you a pair of Russell's pajamas. And tell you what, while you're sleeping, I'll put your clothes in the washer and the dryer, and you'll be all squeaky clean to meet Mum tomorrow, eh?
In water.
Yes, what is it?
Excuse me, Mrs. Davidson, the new arrivals have been checked in.
Well?
One of them has asked to see you.
Well, I can't see her now. Put them through the normal procedure. I'll see them all tomorrow.
Well, she did ask especially
Miss Manson, I know you're new here, but surely you can handle a routine matter such as this.
This is a telecom recording. The number you have dialed is no longer connected. Please check the current Metropolitan Directory.
There isn't any enough. I can't
this
see
is
it.
A telecom recording.
Yeah, I heard ya.
It's no longer connected. Please check the current Metropolitan
Directory. I told you it's
directory.
Not...
Oh, this is a telecom recording.
As long as it's not cauliflower. I was eating cauliflower when the police arrested me. Ever since then, I can't stand it. I only have to smell cauliflower and I throw up. Ha! Here's your tucker.
Yeah, well, not before time.
Gee, must be driving you mad over here, eh?
I'm enjoying the peace and quiet.
Ah,
put that on the table.
Oh, yeah. Paid craft work. It's good, isn't it? Everyone's doing it.
Well, you can just tell everyone to down tools. No more craft work until I give the word.
Oh, but, Bea, they're really enjoying it.
You heard what I said. And tell the girls I'm thinking of them and to behave themselves.
Yeah, sure, Bea, I'll do that. See?
Oh, g'day, Vera. How you been? Still sucking lemons for breakfast?
Who are you?
Oh, Vera, don't you remember me? I'm hurt. I did a stretch in here about 3 years ago.
Myra Desmond.
The very same.
Where's the accompanying officer?
Oh, no, Vera, you got me all wrong. I'm straight as a die now.
Well, what are you doing here?
Just visiting. Prison Reform Group. Mrs. Davidson asked me to see Chrissy Latham.
How did you manage to worm your way into this? Mrs. Davidson's a member.
Mm, of course she is. We've got prison officers and lawyers, ex-crims, hookers, junkies, even cops, all united in a common cause.
Just because you've got the support of some semi-official bunch of do-gooders, don't you try and push your luck with me. Now sign in. You should know the rules.
That's what I like about you, Vera. You're so stirrable.
Oh, that looks great, Chris. You ought to be a chef when you leave school.
No, I'm going to be a plumber like Dad.
Ah, good one. It's a good trade.
As long as you don't fall in trenches.
Oh, well, this scrub certainly looks better than the stuff you get in prison.
You mean in prison?
Yeah. More than once, unfortunately.
What did you do?
Oh, a whole lot of stupid things I was sorry for afterwards.
Were you scared?
Yeah, but you get used to it. Right, that ought to do it. Everyone got somewhere to sit.
Yeah.
Sorry to keep you waiting.
It's okay, Mrs. Davidson. Bea's been filling me in.
Oh, well, let's get started, shall we?
Right. Now, as I understand it, the women are trying to finance the newspaper by taking in extra printing jobs at cut rates.
That's right.
But do you think it's a viable proposition?
What's viable mean?
Shut up and listen. Yeah, I should say so. I mean, printing costs the earth. There's any number of organisations that we're involved with who jump at the chance of getting their work done cheaply.
Well, you reckon we can make a go of it?
Don't see why not.
Here, hot wire. Stick your gear in the car.
Thanks. I mean it.
You got bats in the belfry, Rita. Don't say I didn't warn you.
Well, so much for a crummy idea.
Yeah. Said they'd be knocking down our door in the country.
We just picked the wrong town, that's all.
Oh, did we ever? You said the customer would be a nicer type of bloke. Well, too nice is their trouble.
We'll pack up and move on tomorrow.
I reckon we're going to head back to the city.
No. Now, look, we made a bargain and we're going to stick to it.
Yeah. We all end up refined ladies in a tea shop. Jeez, I was a mug ever listening to your fairy stories.
Listen to me, Gail. There's no future back there. Do you really want to go back again? Back to Jacko beating you up.
Hey, Mrs. Morris.
Yes,
I'm all right.
I was very lucky then.
What's wrong? You're the last person I expected to see in here. You're okay.
I killed Bill, Jude.
Yeah, I know. I know. I'm sorry.
Oh, don't feel sorry. Not for him. Not that bastard. He deserved it. If you're going to feel sorry for the kids. What have they got? The mother's in the slammer. It's time for life. Jude, I've lost the only two people I love. Get out.
Don't you ever go near her again. Do you understand me?
I don't take orders from scum like you. Now get out! Oh. Now don't you ever lay a hand on me again, do you hear me? Not ever. See, Sonia? There's nothing to worry about. Miss Ferguson is a pushover. Thank you, Desmond. You've given me a new lease of life.
Fat stuff, I've had a batter. Guts all you! You were damn lucky in the kitchen, Brian. The next time I have a chance, I'll
play. No, I'll kill you now!
In fact, I reckon you and that pacemaker could do with
it. No!
You all right?
Yes.
Now you listen, Winter, and you listen good. Because I'm only going to tell you this once. I'm going to keep this prison running smoothly, and I don't give a damn what I have to do to you to make sure of that.
Yeah? Well, that's not going to be easy, lady. Because we're both in here for a very long time. Plenty of time to play little games with each other.
I'm all right.
Would you like to sip on something?
I'll get you some paper and a pen. Someone should ring Velda.
Oh, yeah, I'll do that. An hour early at most.
I'm unable to sign the death certificate at this stage.
What do you mean?
Well, even though Charlie was expected to die in the near future, there are some aspects of this case I need to refer to the coroner.
You're sending him for post-mortem?
Yes, I know this is
distressing. What is the point of a post-mortem? We all know that was the emphysema that killed him.
I'm sorry, I'm professionally obliged here. I'm not sure about the quantity of painkillers he consumed in the last few hours.
Of death, the sleep, correct?
Yes.
You heard nothing that might in any way relate to your brother's death?
No, I was asleep. And I must say, this investigation of yours is both inappropriate and misplaced.
Why?
My brother was dying. That he died now, at peace, rather than in a few months' time in great pain, is actually a blessing, not a reason to hound poor Stephanie.
She seems like a very nice person.
Salt of the earth.
Kind, compassionate, caring for her granddad.
Yes, all of that.
Must have been very hard on all of you.
Yes, it was. But we had learnt to manage his physio and his pain relief. Hopefully that made it a bit easier for him.
Is it possible that he just decided to slip away, to take a few more tablets and just drift off?
I don't know.
But he couldn't do it on his own, could he? I mean, he'd need help. He'd need someone there to get the water, someone to open the bottle of pills, a caring, compassionate granddaughter to hold his hand. Is it just possible that Stephanie did exactly what her uncle thought he saw her do?
What if she did? What if she did honour the request of a dying man? Surely it's his right to choose the time of his dying.
Miss Cassidy, I think your niece should get herself a good lawyer. Good day.
Calm down. Now, I only ordered one of these young ladies, and they're not spontaneously cloning. So what's going on?
Don't look at me, Mon. I was expecting a church picnic.
You should have had more faith, Roy. Who's the other culprit?
How can they say you poisoned your husband if he says you didn't?
Yeah, I gotta admit, the whole thing seemed cockeyed to me.
Well, my barrister said it looked bad because of the death of my first husband.
Oh, bloody hell. Did you knock him off too, did you?
Oh, some men will believe anything you tell them. They're so gullible. I mean, take Harry, for instance.
Like this oleander bush, for instance, could do with a bit of attention. Funny how such a dangerous plant can have such delicate flowers, isn't it?
Well, it's only the sap that's poisonous.
Yes, yeah. Yeah, when I was a kid, a friend of mine nearly died from it.
An old bush's trick. What's this for? Here, let me show you.
Oh, thank you. When do I leave, Mrs. Morris?
Well, now, unless you want to keep him waiting.
Oh, dear Harry, I'll write to you, Nora, I promise.
Good on you.
Goodbye. Bye.
Come off it, rabbit. We got more.
Oh! Hey, come on now, quit clowning around.
Good morning, Mrs. Mangle.
Good morning, Mrs. Mangle.
So, it would appear that the ban has been lifted.
Ban? What ban's that, Mrs. Mangle?
Oh, come on, relax, Mrs. Mangle. Nothing that could shock their neighbours could possibly take place in the street, nor in the classroom.
Well, I'm not so sure about that. However, it's your family's problem.
Problem? Oh, no. No, there's no problem at all.
I was wondering if Mrs. Daniels is still at home.
Yeah, well, she is, but she's trying to get ready for work. I don't think she'd be interested in the gossip at the moment.
It certainly is not gossip, Scott.
Can't stop. Sorry, Jennifer, I'm late already.
Just wanted to take a minute.
What's the problem?
Well, you know, the other night at the restaurant, I wasn't going to say anything, but some of those things I told you about people, you won't tell anyone, will you?
Of course not. Wasn't even listening half the time. Only joking. Forget about it.
Well, it's what I told you about Di Miller that worries me.
Can't believe it anyway.
Well, the thing is, I was a bit drunk.
Anything you said won't go any further than me, okay?
Thanks, Wayne. I had a beaut night. Be nice to do it again sometime.
Sure. I'd better go. See you through the day.
Well, I'm worried too. Sorry, it's just that our petition goes to the board today. I'm hoping for a miracle. Uh-oh, here's trouble.
Morning, Dr. Steele. Lovely day.
Yes, it is. Any messages for me?
Not today, but no news is good news.
Ah, Sister Crosgrove to come and see me when she arrives, will you?
Yes, Doctor.
How do I do that? Get words to come out when I've got both feet stuck in my mouth.
Forget about it.
Oh, it's easy for you to say.
Oh, g'day.
Do I owe this honor?
Oh, I just thought we should be mates. Thought maybe I could do a few things for you.
What assistance could I possibly get from you?
None, I suppose. Tell you the truth, I'm scared to death of you. And I thought maybe if you got to know me a bit better, then you just might leave me alone.
That's the most honest thing I've heard since I moved in here.
Great. Well, I've poured us both a cup of tea. I'll just get it. We'll have a toast. Well, it's not exactly like Mum used to make, but at least it's drinkable if you get to the urn early enough. Now, before I come here, I should think everyone in the world made a better cup of tea than me.
You'll miss your family. Oh, dear. I know you meant well, but I really don't like this much milk.
Good for you.
Milk's good for young calves, but I don't like it. You've got no objections to switching, have you? No, I thought not. Mmm. Much better. Oh, bottoms up. Well, I get edgy if I drink alone. You wouldn't want that, would you?
Well, I suppose I'd better retire as well, eh?
Oh, you can't. The night's put a puppy. Can't go to bed yet.
Ah, oh, well, you know, Madge doesn't sleep with
me. Oh, I was hoping you'd stay up and keep me company.
No. I think I'd best.
Oh, come on, Harry. Don't be such a tardy pooper. Let yourself go a little.
Oh, I'm not very good at letting myself go.
Just let the music take you.
All right.
That's good.
Oh,
come on.
Will you please turn that infernal racket off? There are people trying to sleep.
But it's only 9:30.
Yeah, well, I'm trying to sleep.
Sorry, but love, we just...
Yeah, what do you think you're doing jumping around like that? You just had a heart attack, for heaven's sake.
Oh, man.
Don't you omadge me. You just can't help yourself, can you? Come on.
Yes,
digging air raid shelter for Gracie. It was Terry's idea, really, but I'm building it for a minute.
How'd it get so full of water?
We're all right now.
all right, love?
Oh, yes, Harry. Now I have a suggestion, Harry.
What's that, love?
I suggest we scream for help.
Oh, hi. I'm Rob Summer. How come we didn't meet in the rec room?
Let's just say I don't like crowds. Especially that crowd.
Oh, well, that's never nice that much. Actually, once they got me going on my kids, I couldn't stop.
You're all pathetic.
You are evil.
You hit me and I'll tell on all of you.
No one's gonna hit you, Angel. No one's gonna touch you. No one's gonna talk to you. No one is going to acknowledge your presence.
You could just make it you and me from now on if you like. What do you think?
Well, maybe.
What sort of an answer is that?
A girl doesn't like to be rushed, you know. But I'll let you know tonight.
You promise?
Promise. But I do like you heaps.
Hey! Hey! What are you doing? What are you having done to it? Leave me!
Hey! What's going on? Going to think. Oh, look at the two of you. Well, just go and clean yourselves up, will you? Now!
Yeah, well, I'll see you tonight.
Yeah, sure. I've never had a couple of guys fight over me before.
You enjoyed every moment of that, didn't you?
Yeah. So what?
So you're playing them against each other and turning them into enemies.
Well, who cares? They're just a couple of silly kids.
And you're a spoilt little brat. Out to have a good time and you don't care who gets hurt, do you?
Well, that's real funny coming from you. You're the original good time girl, aren't you?
Leave them alone, Wendy.
I'll do what I like and you mind your own business. Stick to your own game, stripper.
Matty! Don't fight him, Matty. I've got to go.
Get out of the way, Leanne. I don't want you getting hurt.
Oh! That's enough! Marty,
you're lucky, pal. I was just about to lose my temper. It wasn't going to be pretty.
You're right.
Oh, you're kidding, this guy. It's chicken feed.
I said that's enough!
Nice to see someone didn't make a fool of themselves.
I've got to go, Marty. If I don't, he'll just keep coming back to the bay.
Well, what about us getting hitched?
I guess it's off. There's nothing I can do. I made a promise.
Are you coming back or?
I don't know.
Let's face it, mate, you've been stiff.
Oh, just shut up or I'll deck you again. I'm sorry, Marty. Honest.
Okay, Smith, Murray, Roberts, Adler, Anderson and Shaw, you're in the laundry.
Somebody give me a hand with this. I can't write anything that doesn't make me sound like I'm real desperate.
Ah, give us a look.
It's that bloke that's a cook for the army.
Well, it's only got his body over here. He couldn't do worse with dinner than Mrs. O'Regan did.
It is.
Thieving bitch, give me back me fags. Get stuck, Winner. They're mine and I'm keeping them.
Oh, yeah, you want a bet?
Keep out of this, you freak!
I'm warning you, Winter.
Save your breath,
Barbara. What the hell's going on?
What does it look like? We're taking over.
Are you crazy?
We're going to tear this place apart.
That's right. We're going to have ourselves a little riot.
Kelly?
No!
It's a razor blade, Screw. A brand new razor blade.
You haven't got a chance. You'll never get away.
Just you watch me. Now just shut up and do as you're told. Or I'll kill you. And I don't want to have to do that, because you're my ticket out of here. And I will if I have to. So you try real hard not to upset me.
Yes.
Understood?
Yes, of course.
Get your keys. Open it. Or get a bloody move on.
I can't see. I'm sorry.
Oh, shut up and open the gate. I knew you could do it.
Please. Please. You're hurting my neck. Please.
Here. Open the door.
Yes. Yes. The key is broken.
Get a bloody move on.
Yes. Yes.
What are they, scared somebody will pinch something?
Oh.
Okay, open it.
What? No, I haven't got the key.
Don't give me that crap. Now, do you want to live or don't you?
Yes.
Then I'll give you till I count three. What? One,
oh, I've
two.
Got, I've got it here.
I thought you might.
I've got it.
She's dead. Now, get up real careful, Screw, and come around here. Other way. Don't do it, Barry, or I'll blow your brains out. You, turn around.
You won't do anything silly now, will you, Kelly?
I wouldn't do nothing stupid.
Oh, no!
See? That's pretty smart in my book.
Oh, for heaven's sake, why don't you give it up?
I'll cut the lectures, dearie, and start tying this mole up.
Oh, I haven't got anything.
Then
to...
use your bloody tie. Oh, I'm warning you, Barry. You're starting to get up me nose.
Oh, no.
And hurry up. I don't want to have to hang around.
No.
You've still got to get through the gates.
Oh, never. You'll never make it. You'll never make it. You'll never get through.
Don't bet on it. Because you know what'll happen if you don't.
What?
Bang!
Yes? Oh, I heard crying.
So?
Is everything all right? Pardon me, but I don't know you from Adam. Oh, I'm sorry. I should have introduced myself. Gail Robinson. I live just up the street. You must be here looking after Jamie.
That's right. Carol Barker.
Oh, I'm sorry, Carol. Nobody told me you'd started. I've never heard him like that before. Are you sure he's all right?
Do I seem worried?
Well, he sounds pretty distressed.
Look, the only thing that's wrong with that little rascal is he's too used to getting his own way. Once he realises that no one is paying the slightest bit of attention, those crocodile tears will dry up and all this nonsense will stop. Now, if there's nothing else...
It's just that it's not like Jamie. I wonder if you wouldn't mind checking up on him for me. Or better still, why don't I?
I had no instructions from his father to let anyone in except Mrs. Daniels, and she's already been.
Did she see Jamie?
She did. And now, if you'll excuse me, I have a lot to do.
There's no way we can land the Nomad there. The nearest airstrip would be here, 20 kilometres away.
What about a helicopter?
A chopper would be smashed against the walls.
Lower someone down on a rope.
They'd be smashed against the walls.
Well, it's not just the broken leg, Jack. By the sound of it, it could be developing compartmental syndrome. It's a very painful condition. The leg's broken in two points.
Yeah, but can he be moved?
Well, not at the moment, not before correct splinting and analgesia.
So much for axe track technology. Well, we've got to get him out somehow.
Not by air.
No, not by air. We'll drive. Look, if you can fly us into that nearest airstrip, we'll borrow a four-wheel drive and head in as far as we can. DJ, I want you to contact that Pete. Now, this is critical, DJ. You tell him that he's got to remain there with Luke, but all the women, including Paula, must come out in that axe track. Now, make up any excuse you can, anything you like, but all the women must come out. We'll pick them up here where they left their four-wheel drive. And Chris and I will take the axe track and go in and pick up Luke.
He left that and headed off in the axe track.
I thought as much.
You know what the land's like. Chances of seeing anything are hopeless.
I will keep looking for as long as your fuel supply will allow, then head back. All we can do apart from that is wait till Alex decides to call.
Do you want to brave it?
Yeah. After you.
Thanks. After you.
Maybe. Debbie, see if you can raise them again, would you?
Mike Sierra Foxtrot calling Billaluna Station. Are you there, Billaluna Station?
Where the hell are they?
Are we planning on flying all the way to their property?
I don't know.
Because if we don't head for the clinic soon, we're not going to make it today.
Yeah, well, maybe we can just go on for a few more minutes, eh?
Okay.
Hey, what's up there? It's him. Debbie, get onto DJ. What? Tell him there's been an accident.
You go sailing that.
Shared ownership of something does not include the right to destroy it. Now, Mrs. Fordham, you knew that we couldn't just stand by and let that incident pass, so why did you go ahead and do it?
You've been completely betrayed.
That still doesn't explain why you would destroy your own property.
Doesn't it? 9 weeks ago, I came back from Japan, having just signed the biggest deal of our careers. To discover that he and Miss Mealymouth had been playing star-crossed lovers. And I'm the demon bitch from hell.
Mrs. Fordham, we understand how you feel, but...
I would have been happy to have listened to any excuse. But he just calmly asked me for a divorce and said he wanted to continue in the business 50-50. He even had a document for me to sign. Fine, I said. Let's start with this piece of paper. And I tore it in half.
As much as we might sympathise, it still doesn't give you the right to set about cutting up the bone.
25 years we've been together. And not so much as I'm sorry.
Mrs. Fordham, you could find yourself faced with charges of criminal damage.
Good morning, sister.
Good morning. I hear you had a lively old night over at Bunny.
Well, you could say that. Maybe I should try the live entertainment bit.
Maybe.
Oh, your discharge is from D.
Oh, thanks, Mike.
You heard from Wayne?
No.
I think I said more than I should have the other night. I'm sorry if I upset you.
Oh, you didn't.
I say too much. Sometimes I think I shouldn't.
Always be honest, Mike. There are too many people in this world who aren't. Wayne.
Yes. Well, if you'll excuse me, sister. Got a few things to do.
Well, you all right?
Yes, what are you doing here?
Well, I couldn't find you in the dining room. I got a bit worried about you. Not like you to go off your tucker.
Oh, yeah, that'd be right. Old garbage guts, that's me.
Oh, no, I didn't mean that. What's wrong?
everything. I don't know. This place. Some of the people in it. Me being a bloody idiot.
Careful. Now you're talking about a mate of mine.
Am I? I mean, thanks. I need all the mates I can get.
Can I sit down?
I mean, it's probably just Bobby leaving. She could be a bloody nerd when she wanted to be, but geez, we had some good times. And Jude, well, you know how terrific she is, and look what the buggers have done to her. Have to be a bloody nana to believe she'd actually do that.
But isn't that what she wanted in...
To top it all off, the way I carried on out there. I saw a bit of blood and I started screaming my head off. I mean, Lexi wasn't crying.
I meant it, but I didn't mean
it. What are you doing here, Delaney?
Sorry, Miss Ferguson. I was just worried about Marlene.
Well, now she can worry about you, can't she? You're on a charge. Get out.
Jim wanted the baby. But even if everything had worked out, I still wouldn't have gone back to him. It was over.
Did you want the baby?
Yes, I did. I'm not ashamed of what happened. I wouldn't blame you, though, if you were unhappy about it. I was going to tell you.
I see.
Look, I don't want to have to go through it all again. So if you're going to go, please do it now.
I'm not making any judgments, Zoe. I don't have the right. It's just... Well, it just came as a bit of a shock.
That your girlfriend's looking forward to the party? She's coming down for it, isn't she?
Now, why would I bore you with my private life?
Just wondering when we're going to get to meet her.
Well, if I were you, I'd spend less time wondering about that and more time learning the music.
Well, I just want to see the poor woman who gets stuck with you, sir.
Libretto, read, learn. Oh, very good, Miss Stewart. Glad you could make it, Miss Stewart. OK, let's go to work, people.
I'm afraid I can't, Mr. Foley.
Sorry?
I'm looking for my niece. Have you seen her?
No, why should I? She isn't in the show.
Oh, of course. I just thought that she may have...
Eloped?
What's that supposed to mean?
I hear there are wedding bells in there.
Idle gossip is the devil's instrument, Carly. I'd expect you to know better.
Oh, that's good, coming from you.
Carly.
It's true. Look, she was happy enough to gossip about me. It's different when it's about her. She wants everyone to shut up.
I'd be stupid to pretend I was blameless in that instance, Carly, but I did apologize. And I think it's very spiteful of you to bear a grudge. I won't keep you.
Dum, dum, da, dum, dum, dum.
Look, how late did you get in last night anyway?
Pretty late.
I bet you really got it going. How late was it?
It was late. About 3 o'clock.
What were you doing till 3 o'clock in the morning?
I was with Mike Giorgio. We had dinner at his place.
Till 3 o'clock?
Papa just went off his head. You will try and straighten it out for me, won't you?
Oh, you bet I will. You can count on it.
Yes, that's all I want to say. Look, I would have wanted to be. If I did, it certainly wouldn't be wrong. So, don't find yourself another show to cry. I've got problems with nothing. Leave me alone.
Get yourself.
Don't touch me.
Aren't you having pains?
Yes.
Bad pains?
Yes.
Has she been crying out?
No. Shouldn't we take her to a hospital?
I'm not going to a hospital. Please get him out of here. They'd never miss me.
Sure, love? It's going to be very risky.
Just tell me what I have to do.
So they got machine guns. How many?
Three. No, maybe four. I don't know. There's already somebody on guard. I'm not sure.
Think, girl. It's important. Look, Julie, we're going to get you out of here. We've got to know what we're up against. Okay, now how many men are there?
They've started shooting us.
How many, Julie? 11, 12, what?
Three. There's only three of them.
Three?
Yeah, three. And Mrs. Ballinger.
Clever little bitch, aren't you? Now get down real slow and don't even breathe in the wrong place.
You go ahead and cry. We did. Are you all right, Julie? Did you reach a telephone?
Yeah, I got Inspector Grace. I told him everything. He said no one else would get killed.
Oh, God, how much longer?
What'd you come back for anyhow? You could have been out by now.
I couldn't just leave you all.
Do you know how I found out? Billy. Our own son had to tell me his father was having an affair.
Oh, no, sister,
how do you think that made me feel? I was so ashamed. I was completely humiliated.
Please, will you listen to me? I love you.
Don't you dare! You must have so little respect for me if you could just lie and cheat and betray me like that. Oh, I trusted you. I believed everything you ever said to me.
Oh, no, Susan.
Don't you touch me!
What do you think you're doing in this corridor unsupervised? I could put you on report for this.
Look, I'm supposed to be here. I'm taking this stuff to the laundry. You put me on report for this. God, you really haven't got a clue, have you?
Don't you dare.
I know. Don't you dare speak to me like that. Am I supposed to be scared of you or something? You know, we all think you're a big joke acting like Vera and looking exactly like you do, like a stupid little kid.
I'll forget you said that this time. Now just get onto the laundry. I'll be in to check on you, so no games.
Oh, and I had such big plans too.
What is it?
I beg your pardon?
You sent for me. Smith said it was important.
You still haven't learned. You can never trust these women.
Those bitches. I'll teach them. Screw. All right, Smith, what's the idea?
What idea?
You know damn well Miss Bennett didn't want to see me. What's so funny, Burns? Right!
Got all your mates in here holding your hand. Come on, the jug's boiling. Make the bloody coffee. You make one for me too.
Oh, that's right.
You don't have coffee at night, do you? AM coffee and PM tea.
That's right. It's not true that you suffer from PMS at all, is it?
Well, I don't know, but I'm not lying about it.
Your depressions don't exactly fit with your menstrual periods. How do you explain that?
I told you, I don't know.
You just proved the point by attempting suicide when you should be perfectly all right.
Well, I was upset.
Normal people don't try to commit suicide just because they're upset.
I insist you stop.
Were you upset over Ben Fulbright? What were you thinking about when you were tying the noose to hang yourself?
Oh, I'm going to get the governor. If you leave me alone, or I'll kill you. I promise I'll kill you.
Stephen, I want to talk to you, please.
Can't wait. I've got to go.
No.
Pippa?
Stephen, I know where you really stayed last night.
I suppose Ben told you.
Yes, he did.
Yeah, that'd be right.
Only after I had to drag it out of him.
Suppose you don't approve.
Oh, that's an understatement. You know I don't, otherwise you wouldn't have lied to me.
Jennifer needs me. I'm not going to let her down. Her husband's a maniac. You should have seen what he did to the paintings. She's scared.
Stephen, I am more concerned about what she's doing to you. Your HSC is very close now. Now, you need the time that you're spending with her to devote to your studies.
What I don't know now, I'll never know.
Oh, that's rubbish. You know how important last-minute revision is.
Pippa, I'll be all right. She's something special. She really is.
Yes, and she should know better than to get involved with someone your age.
What difference does age make? You wouldn't say anything if Ben was 9 years older than Carly.
Oh, that's different.
Why is it different?
It just is, that's all. Now, can you imagine what everyone's going to say when they find out about you two?
I don't care. It's nobody else's business. Pippa, I'm sorry, but if you don't like it, it's bad luck. And don't tell me not to see her. I don't want to go against you, but... Well, I will if you force me.
I have not been pushing drugs.
We'll see. In the meantime, you're suspended until a full inquiry has been held.
Suspended? Do you think I want to work in this hole ever again? Like hell, I quit.
I'm sure we'll exist without you.
We're arriving to be checked in, a friend of yours.
Hello, Vera. I missed you at Lawson.
That's enough of that, Yates. Stand over there.
Good old Vera, the professional screw. I think you've got this all wrong.
Have I?
It wasn't my fault that Sally died.
Of course it was.
Well, it was just a job to me.
Sure.
I needed the money.
You know, trouble with you a lot. Yates, they want. Oh, you want to play?
Need any help, babe?
I'll play.
No, it's all right. Just keep watching. This rat's just throw a show its teeth, that's all.
Come any closer, you're gonna get bit.
Really? You're a real little spitfire, aren't you?
No, he's changed his mind.
So what's the story?
I'm taking it back to him tonight.
And we just sit tight here waiting for our money? I don't think so.
Oh, no. No, Mr. Cooper said I could pay you now.
Oh!
the gun down.
He just killed her. He shot her. She didn't stand a chance.
We've got him now. Willie, there's no point in you spending the rest of your life in prison for filth like him. Now put the gun down.
Gladys. She used to go there quite a lot.
Yeah, do you remember her second name?
She had dark hair. Oh, there she is.
All right.
And that one. There.
Good, good. Do you remember where she lived? That might give us a clue.
Sorry.
You have to try, Carmel.
I am trying. Actually, you know, it was Glenys.
Yep.
Oh, but come to think of it, she went to live in America or Canada or somewhere. I don't think Susan ever saw her again.
Well, perhaps if you have a think about what Susan was like back then, the things that she enjoyed doing, you know, that might give us some idea where she went.
Yes, well, she had a really rebellious streak. She was very headstrong.
Well, that much hasn't changed, has it?
She was always getting grounded. Not that that'd stop her, of course. She'd just climb out of the bedroom window and take herself up to some rock concert or other.
Did she go on her own or with other people?
Well, sometimes on her own and sometimes with other people. I wish I could remember this guy's name. She was mad about him. I don't know what she ever saw in him, though. Made the mistake of telling her once, and not a good move.
Oh, we need a name, Carmel.
I think I was living in Fernhill Park at the time, and Darcy would have been a toddler. And, oh, boy, was he a handful. Oh, what a set of lungs. Do you know, he used to keep me up all night, that
Carmel,
kid.
Please, for heaven's sake, this is serious. I don't think you realise how serious it is.
I do realise that, Carl. Don't forget, Susan's my sister. And if you had looked after her a bit better, we wouldn't be in this situation. So don't you go blaming me, OK?
I just want to tell you one thing. It's over. We're finished.
2 years in a cell on my own is a long time. But if you've got the key, perhaps we could get together.
Don't be disgusting.
I want protection.
You'll be safe.
I hate them as much as you do, Mr. Stewart. I was just thinking, maybe you and I could be of use to each other.
In what way?
Well, you could always see I get a few of the comforts of home, and I'll keep quiet about what I just heard.
You know, I think you and I will go on just fine, Gilmore. Just fine.
Something wrong?
Yes. How's your business last night?
Oh, good. Very good.
So you'll be coming round tonight then?
Oh, Terry, no, I'm sorry. I can't. I'm on a split shift. I've got to get back here tonight.
I see.
Have I done something wrong?
I thought we were friends.
We are.
So why don't we spend any time together? You've always got something on. It feels like you're shutting me out.
Oh, I'm not.
Well, if that's what you want, just tell me. I'm a big girl. I'll cope.
Oh, come on, Terry. I'm not shutting you out. In fact, it's quite the opposite. Look, you're important. Far too important to risk in this nonsense with Desmond and Ballinger. And that's something I had to handle myself. Sorry if I hurt you.
We can start again. We've got something worth saying.
We have nothing, Joan, nothing. You, almighty, all-powerful freak. You knew I slept with Barry, and yet you let me get away with it.
Because I thought we had something worth saving.
Why didn't you scream at me? At least I could have understood that. Why didn't you hit me or throw things? Why in God's name did you just do nothing?
Because I was frightened of losing you.
You lost me anyway.
I want you to have this because God knows. I reckon you've earned it.
I don't know what to say. To...
Look after that hubby of yours, eh? He's a lucky bloke.
Thanks for this, Tom. I'll treasure it.
Spot of polish once a month won't hurt either. I love you, Jean.
Don't, Tom.
Won't be long, Tom. I want to see Danny off. Drive carefully.
No worries.
Wedding, wasn't it? I was engaged to Daphne once, but it didn't work out though. She's always loved Des. Well, now that she's got him, I hope it just all works out for the best. I'm sorry, Jean, I'll shut up, okay?
I've read Matron's memo. What are you doing tomorrow?
You propositioning me?
Sort of. Are you doing anything special?
Well, I'm having drinks with the Steels mid-morning, but then Toby's phoning in the afternoon, so I decided against going out.
Oh, listen, that's great. Eve invited me so we can meet there and then go back to your place and cook a Christmas lunch for you.
Oh, I would have thought you'd have something more exciting to do than that.
Well, frankly, so did I, but it'd be great to talk to Toby and Aunt Laura.
Well, I think I've got a few tomatoes and eggs in the fridge, but that's about all, I'm afraid.
Well, I'll grab a chicken and a few other goodies for my break. I'm no Susan Richards, but I can cook.
Well, that sounds pretty good. I expect your mother was disappointed you couldn't get home.
Yeah, well, I'm not due for a break, so she understood. Anyway, I promised her I'd phone. Hey, now I can do it at your expense.
Wait! It's about what happened upstairs, I can explain. It wasn't just Kate Chris was trying to help, it was me too. It's about the attempts on my life. Chris knew there was a risk in us meeting bridges. He was trying to talk us out of it.
We all know Tim's is a devious man.
Don't tell me he appealed to your vanity. I won't buy it.
Have you ever shut up and listened to yourself? Your chauvinism I put up with, but denigrating my abilities as a cop is a line that nobody crosses. Even Tim's knows that.
What the hell are you talking about? I never meant for a second you
weren't... That's right. You don't mean to. You don't try to. It's unconscious. You can't help yourself.
They are very heavy people, love. I care about you.
I know that too. But, Jeff, the bottom line is that you don't think I can do the job. I've never been an equal in your eyes, and I don't think I ever will be.
Oh, to hell with all of that.
Amazing thing is it took someone like Tim's to make me realize it.
Tim's is a public schoolboy. All he cares about is blue elephant stamps and gold stars.
Yeah, maybe. But he's willing to risk all of that on me, and you won't even give me house room. No, they welded at the security grills after the siege. Flynn got a pair of bolt cutters from somewhere.
You still up there?
I don't know. Madison didn't try to cut her way out. She went over the fence.
Well, full of information, aren't we?
What's the good of being the phantom lagger if you don't have good information?
What?
That's right. You just struck a game.
Hope you're not playing games with me, Wilder.
Oh, I've been playing games for weeks. But not with you. And those stupid bitches. Especially Kelly and I have loved every minute of it.
Well, you took a hell of a risk. All right? Now I'm prepared to take a few with you.
Good. You should be grateful to me.
I saved your life, Miss Ferguson.
Who put me in there?
Like I said in the note, Kelly, with Lurch supplying the muscle power.
Yeah, and what about that alibi that Kelly was with Patterson?
It's easy. Patterson hates pain. Kelly
made a sound. What's going on? I could have helped you, Luke. Oh!
Very bad mistake, Wilder.
Speak to her.
Tie her up and gag her.
But we've got to be fair. And I just remembered something. We didn't give her a trial.
do we? Hands up for not guilty. And guilty?
This isn't the place. We can settle this later.
No way!
No! I've been hearing a lot of things going on behind my back, and I don't think I like it.
Someone had to keep the place running.
Running! You've got him bolting for the door.
You've changed a lot, Maxwell. From shy little kid killer to first-class pain in the neck.
They had a very good teacher.
I earn respect, Maxwell. I don't shove it down people's throats.
Is that what you're doing now, earning respect?
You don't count as people.
Things are changing around here, Connors. You're fighting a losing battle.
At least I'm doing it one-to-one. This one's for Laurie. That one's for Lexi. Now it's just a little matter of that protection record of yours.
Touch me again and you'll regret it.
I'm gonna ram your head through this wall. Might knock some sense into you.
You'll go to Blackmore, I swear it. I mean it, Connors. They'll throw the key away.
You wouldn't be planning on lagging on me, would you, Lexi?
There are ways of letting the screws find out about this, including Ferguson.
Ferguson's already tried the scare of Blackmore on me. Forget it.
She's still gunning for you. And I'll let her have the bullets if you force me.
Who says you won't anyway?
It'll suit you just fine if I get hauled off, I reckon.
Not if you stay out of my business.
Let you fleece the girls rotten. I meant what I said about Blackmore, so help me. Hell.
Just put yourself on a charge, Connors. Assaulting an officer. Solitary.
Yeah. What do you reckon?
That's
girls?
It, Connors. Come on.
Oh, but you can't take me, Mr. Evans. You're in pain.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
Gonna get them for what they did. You hairy little bastard. I love you.
The entry wound is 20 millimetres across. There's also soot in the wound track, which indicates extreme proximity. So Lance was right.
This surprises you, Imogen?
There are four exit wounds in the victim's back, so the weapon is a shotgun of some description. It also explains the number of pellets I'm finding still in the body.
Yeah, I think you'll find that it was a 12-gauge shot. I found a couple of used shells on the floor of the shop.
A pacifist who kills people.
Maybe he thinks it's for the greater good. He had access to Kylie's keys to the shop.
He did. I'll have a cast of the neck in 20 minutes, OK? That will help us identify what was used in the decapitation.
Anyone offer? Do yourself a favour. Professional rates, of course.
No. Really? I think all I need to look 10 years younger is a week off. Not a facelift.
Dr. Pollock.
You left me quite a mess to clean up with that pappas boy.
He was tensioning. I had to make a call.
You did a good job. But what you did for that boy, under that kind of pressure, was remarkable. Actions speak louder than words, and your actions showed us that this hospital is very lucky to have you on staff. But the way you conducted yourself at the interview was also remarkable, for all the wrong reasons.
I know. I wasn't at my best that day.
You were arrogant, self-absorbed. You acted as if you didn't even have to try.
Miss Girdwood.
Dr. Lawson, not one of the other candidates was late or rude or, what shall we say, tired and emotional. That's why they were chosen. So short of one of them being hit by a bus, there's no place for you on the programme this year.
Starting to think you weren't coming.
I was held up in casualty and Tony was there. If I left any earlier, I would have noticed. I could hardly tell him where I was going, could I? Oh, gin and tonic, please.
Yes, ma'am.
Well?
We gotta sort this thing out once and for all.
There's nothing to sort out. I'm marrying Tony, and that's all there is to it.
The biggest mistake you're ever likely to make in your life. That's what we're talking about. I'm not going to let you do it.
Thank you. It has absolutely nothing at all to do with you.
It has everything to do with me. I love you.
So does Tony.
Maybe. But you don't love Tony. You're in love with me.
You really believe that, don't you?
Charlene, do we have to charge her?
Well, Mike said she was committing an offence and we've got to go through with it.
I know that, Sarge, but she was in an emotional state when it's happened. It's taken me this long to try and straighten her out.
What are you talking about? She was drunk.
She'd been drinking, but that's not the root of a problem.
What's the matter with her?
It's about a little boy. People are starting to call him nasty names.
Well, that's hardly our fault, is it?
No, it's not. But in her frame of mind and with a little bit of encouragement, we may well get her off the game. She may try and start a new life for herself.
Look, do you think she'd ever do that?
I don't know. But if we don't give her encouragement and try and get her off the game, Sarge, I don't know who else will.
Well, I reckon we should give her a break.
About Charlene, can we let her off the hook with a bit of a talking to?
Oh, I've been giving her a big sob story, has she?
It's not that. It's just that she's so far down and if we don't help her out, I don't know what'll happen to her, Mike.
Are you sure she's not just conning you?
I'm sure.
Have you heard the evidence, Eric?
Yeah, look, I think a lecture might be the best bet, Mike.
Well, if she's tugged the strings of your hard, all heart, Eric, I reckon there must be something to her story.
All right. But you deliver the lecture, OK?
Thank you.
Lydia, are you all right?
But you were craving it.
He tried to get to it, didn't he?
The bastard tried putting a hole in me with one of these babies.
We haven't got a chance against him, Rick.
You just leave him to me. Listen, they'll be here in a minute. Can you take care of this? If they trace the alarms back here, there's bound to be a cell search.
I'll look after it.
You better look after it because it's all we've got against Craven.
He's got to be stopped, Reed.
You leave that to me now. Get moving!
They refuse to move off. They threaten direct action if Craven is removed from the prison immediately.
If there is evidence to warrant an investigation, I'll see to it myself.
Miss Bates! Miss Bates! Not
now, Wilkinson!
Look, it's about Craven. You've got no idea what he's trying to do. He's trying to kill everybody!
Well, come to my office this afternoon. Tell me all about it then.
Mrs. Look, Morris.
I'll come back and see you. You just rest now.
Oh, please, you have to do something.
Doing all I've got!
We've got to get professional help.
Yes.
Otherwise, your little girl is his.
You these as a first day prezzy.
Oh, Connie, you are sweet.
Yeah. I reckon you should call them after Norm at the pub. He's always desperate for a drink too.
How I think I know where Beatty's got a vase.
Oh, cool. Janet, it's a bit more upmarket than a cleaning job, isn't it?
I can't believe my luck.
Oh, luck's got nothing to do with it, love. You deserve all this. It's onward and upward from here.
Mm. Except for Marty. He called this morning while you're in the shower.
What does he want, money?
No, Marty's not like that. I'm not quite sure what he wanted. He mumbled something about Warren and he having a fight. But I'm not going to let anything spoil my day today. Not even money. Marty, I won't be blackmailed. Now, as soon as you've grown up enough to discuss this rationally, we'll talk again.
If you wanted to meet some of the locals, I'd suggest you pop into the diner. My wife, Ailsa, runs it.
Elsa? Oh, what a lovely name.
Yeah, I like it. Ah, just in time.
I've been round to your place looking for Elsa.
Oh, she's at a party. You know Elsa?
Oh, I know her very well. Although it has been quite a while.
Well, if you'd like to give me a name, I could get her to give you a call.
My name's Bridget Jackson. I'm Elsa's sister.
I'm here to collect Emma and take her home.
Nothing to say. There's a lot I've got to say to you. I'm not leaving Summer Bay until you hear me out. Suit yourself.
Emma, please.
All right. Let's get it over and done with.
Better than a postcard. Carol! What are you doing here?
Oh, darling, look, you sounded like you needed a bit of support, and if Muhammad can't come to the mountain, then I'm going to come to you, because we are a team, after all.
Oh, and you couldn't have come at a better time.
Oh, Harold.
Oh, sorry.
Ah, you must be the famous Jared, are you?
Jared, I should like you to meet Carolyn.